We spend a lot of time on taking a complicated problem, breaking it apart, looking at the pieces, looking at how they fit together, and then putting those pieces back together.
Hopkins Extreme Materials Institute is really a wonderful collection of scientists focused on how materials perform in extreme environments.
The Institute provides a home for interdisciplinary research at extreme conditions. It opens up, you know, new avenues and new approaches that I never would have thought of before.
Really, the reason HEMI came to being is because there were domains of technology and science where multiple things happened at the same time as the system begins to fail, and that no one really understood how those things came together.
A lot of good fundamental science happens with a small group of researchers just sitting and thinking deeply about a problem for a long time, but how to translate that into a real-world application is very difficult. And that's where you need these really large teams to actually take that fundamental science and make it somehow useful for society.
We're trying to learn more than just make a better material in that one class. We're trying to learn the science that would allow us, even if we change alloy systems or we change material systems, in order to be able to evolve that into the future.
We are developing new processes of studying these materials. That is as important as developing a new weapon or a new armor.
If we're able to make the material lighter as well as improve the material property, this could impact the entire defense community.
One of the major things we do is called the MARC conference. It tends to be they come to this meeting because they learn something different. And we think that's really the way these conferences should be.
It's one of the most focused and relevant conferences that I know of. Essentially, everyone who's anyone in the field is here.
We recognize that most people have difficulty understanding these complex problems, not because of the technical difficulty, but because it's hard to see how the pieces fit together.
And we thought, well, we've got a top arts and design program right down the street from Hopkins. We should take advantage of that and pull together with them to look at our problems in a totally different way.
There are some natural synergies between art and science, art and engineering, that this program literally allows us to kind of explore.
We have a variety of things like short courses and workshops, internships, and research experiences of various sorts.
Extreme Science Internship Program was started several years ago at Morgan State University.
It really gave me a holistic view of what it meant to be a researcher, a scientist, a thinker, a STEM student, all those things. It shows me in real time what it is I'm aiming for.
The breadth of kind of research activities that is done is very unique. I am not aware of any other institution that encompasses the length scales and time scales that researchers at HEMI can boast of.
The big strength of this is that we're all thinking about the same thing and sharing the data. The collaboration is what makes the science possible.
We study matter in extreme conditions. We don't know where that's going to go or what's going to come out of these collaborations, but bringing people that study extreme conditions from different angles allows us to then open up new frontiers.
I think we've got a lot ahead of us, a lot of exciting things.